Hi, I'm Dr. John Shim, and I'd like to explain why disc herniations cause pain. But before we can do that, we need to go over some basic anatomy. The intervertebral disc is made of two main components. The outer component of the disc is called the annulus fibrosus. It's a very tough structure designed to be a ligament and designed to hold the soft inner component, the nucleus pulposus, in place. The nucleus pulposus is typically full of water, and at least when you're young, has a jelly-like consistency. The nucleus pulposus functions as a shock absorber. With this two-component design, the disc has three overall functions. Number one, it's a ligament that prevents the spine bones from dislocation, yet allows motion. Number two, it's a shock absorber that prevents the spine bones from colliding and breaking. And number three, it's a spacer, creating room for the nerve roots to come out of the center of the spine and travel to its respective areas of sensation and respective muscles for function. While an elegant design, discs do wear out, and the central part of the disc, the nucleus pulposus, can come out of its normal location and rupture or herniate, potentially causing numbness and weakness. The cause for the herniation is usually multifactorial and can include factors such as genetics, aging, and trauma. Pain is caused by two main mechanisms. Number one, there are many chemicals that are contained within the nucleus pulposus, and these chemicals can and usually do cause an inflammation. I like to say it's like an acid spill on the nerves and the nerve roots. Number two, there is mechanical effect of pressure on the specific nerve roots. The pressure on the nerve roots cause irritation. Because the nerve roots are bundled together to form the longer nerve bundles that go down the arms or legs, whenever the large nerve bundles are stretched, it will cause more irritation of the nerve roots, therefore causing more pain. Luckily, most disc herniations get better. Usually the body reacts to this acid spill by sending special types of cells to remove or mop up the acid. That is why the initial herniation causes such significant pain, but over time the chemical spill is cleaned up and the pain lessens. The body also sees the disc herniation as damaged tissues, and other cells also work to remove this disc material. Over time, most disc herniations lessen in size and no longer cause pain, weakness, and numbness. I'm Dr. John Shim, and I hope you now have a better understanding on why disc herniations cause pain. Thank you.